Good morning, everyone. Today we are going to start with our chapter number 7, Getting to Know Plants. Plants are all around us and we depend on them for our survival. We see a wide variety of plants with different shapes and sizes, different colored flowers, different types of leaves, etc. Some plants are small, some are big. Some have weak stems and others have hard stem. Some have branches arising from the base, while in others the branching occurs at the top. So in this chapter, we will learn about different types of plants and their different parts such as root, stem, leaves, flowers, etc. On the basis of the height, stem type, and branching pattern, plants can be classified essentially into three major categories, that is, herbs, shrubs, and trees. Herbs are the small plants with height less than 4 feet. Their stems are green, delicate, and tender. In herbs, branches may or may not be present and they live only for 1 or 2 seasons. The most common examples that we see around us is grass, tomato, mint, radish, wheat, rice, etc. Our second category is that of the shrubs. Shrubs are medium-sized plants with hard and woody stems which are not very thick. They look bushy as they have many branches that arise near the base of the stem. They live for many years, but their lifespan is less than that of the trees. Most common examples are hibiscus, rose, lemon, jasmine, etc. Trees are tall, big plants with height that may reach to many meters. They have hard, thick, and brown main stem that is commonly known as a trunk. Their branches arise from nearly the top of the stem and spread much above the ground. Their lifespan is of several years. The most common examples are neem, mango, banyan, peepal, gulmohar, etc. While walking around a garden or a park, you must have come across certain plants which have weak stems. Their stems are so weak that they cannot even stand upright. Such type of plants have been classified into 2 major categories, that is, creepers and climbers. Let us first of all discuss about the creepers. Creepers are the plants with weak stems that cannot stand upright, and that is why they grow along the ground, that is, they spread prostrate on the ground. They do not climb up even with the help of a support because they bear very heavy fruits, for example, pumpkin, watermelon, muskmelon, etc. On the other hand, climbers are also having weak stem, but their stems, they are long and flexible. That is why they take support of the walls or other plants to climb up. These plants, they do not bear heavy fruits. Some of the climbers, they twine around the supporting plant or any other support in a spiral manner, like you must have seen money plant. Whereas the other plants, they produce hooks and tendrils to climb, for example, pea plant. A plant has various parts to perform different functions. The 2 main plant systems are shoot system and root system. The green part of the plant that grows above the ground is known as the shoot system. It consists of stem, leaves, buds, flowers, fruits, etc. Whereas the underground part of the plant, which is non-green and remains in the soil, is known as the root system. It consists of a number of roots and their branches. Let us now discuss these two systems in detail. Root is the underground, non-green part of the plant, which fixes it to the soil. It always grows towards gravity and moisture and away from light. For observing the root system, gently pull out a grass plant and a mustard plant from the soil without damaging their roots. Now wash off their roots with plenty of water and observe carefully. You will see that these two plants have different types of roots. These types of roots are known as taproot system and the fibrous root system. In taproot system, the main root, called the taproot or the primary root, it comes out from the seed. It is thicker at its upper part and generally tapers downward. The primary root or the taproot gives out several branches in every direction. These smaller branches are known as lateral or secondary roots. Mango, neem, pine, carrot are some examples of the plants in which taproot system is found. Look at the picture given below of a carrot plant. In a carrot plant, there is a main root. This main root, it is the taproot, and this taproot, it gives out several lateral branches. You must have observed the carrots yourself also. The second type of root system is known as fibrous root system. In this type of root system, a bunch of thin, fiber-like roots arise from the base of the stem. There is no main root here, as all the roots, they are similar in size. These similar roots are known as fibrous roots. Grass, maize, wheat, onion and rice are some common plants in which fibrous root system is found. Now let us discuss a few differences between the taproot system and the fibrous root system. First difference is obviously that in taproot system, one prominent taproot or primary root is present, which gives out small lateral secondary branches, whereas in fibrous root system, all the roots are similar sized and they arise from the base of the stem. Secondly, as the taproot, it grows vertically deep into the soil, these roots, they anchor the plant very firmly as compared to the plants having fibrous roots, because the fibrous roots are shorter and they mostly grow horizontally in the soil. That is why anchoring ability in case of fibrous root system is comparatively low. You can observe it clearly yourself also, that it is very easy to pull out grass, whereas the other plants like mustard, carrots, etc., they are not easy to pull out because their roots are very deep, whereas in case of grass, as it grass has fibrous roots, the roots are only horizontal, therefore it comes out easily. The next difference between taproot system and fibrous root system is that taproot system is seen to exist in dicotyledonous plants. You must have studied in junior classes that the plants in which seeds have two cotyledons are known as dicotyledonous plants, like rajma, beans, etc. These plants, they usually have reticulate venation. This you will study later on as we progress in the next lecture. So the plants which are dicotyledonous and have reticulate venation, they usually have taproot system. Whereas the plants which are monocots, like maize, everybody has seen corn seeds. The corn seeds, they are monocotyledonous. So these types of plants, they have got fibrous root system and they always display play parallel venation. Now let us discuss the main functions of the root. First function of the root is fixation. Roots spread out into the soil and hold the plant firmly to the ground. This prevents the plant from being pulled out easily or blown away by the wind. Second function of the roots is absorption and conduction. Roots absorb water and minerals from the soil and pass them to the stem. Plant uses these water and minerals for manufacturing food and carry out basic life processes. Roots also help in preventing soil erosion by binding the soil particles together. Roots of some plants are modified to perform some additional functions. Let us study these modifications and their functions. First modification is for storage of food. In plants like carrot, turnip, radish, sweet potato, beetroot, etc., the roots are swollen due to storage of food. These are known as storage roots. In plants like banyan tree, you will find some rope-like growths hanging down from the bigger branches. These rope-like growths are known as prop roots. These prop roots get fixed to the soil and act like a pillar to provide additional support to the heavy spreading branches of the banyan tree. You must have heard about the mangrove plants. Mangrove plants are the plants which grow in salt lakes and marshy areas where soil contains very less air. So, these types of plants, they develop special roots which come out of the soil and are known as pneumatophores or the breathing roots. These roots, they grow vertically upward from the underground root of the plant, come out of the water and marsh and help in exchange of gases. That's it for today. In the next lecture, we will study about the shoot system.